Hey guys, it's Jordan, not Jordan, and welcome and welcome back to my channel.
You say hi, we stay high, you look so pretty, yeah.
So today I'm gonna be filming a review of over 15 of my favorite brand, The Ordinary's products. Now I know you're probably wondering, Jordan, this is a skincare review, why the heck are you wearing a full face of makeup? And that is because The Ordinary actually has a foundation. And so that's the first thing that I'm gonna be reviewing today. So The Ordinary has two foundation. One is their serum foundation and one is their coverage foundation. So I currently have their coverage foundation and it's the one I'm wearing today. I'll give you a little bit of a close-up so you can see how it is looking on the skin. As you can see, it has a super nice flawless finish and it is only $6.90 Canadian. I don't wear foundation like that. Honestly, I only wear concealer, but there are certain times when my skin has a lot of hyperpigmentation and I need a little bit more coverage than the concealer can provide. So obviously I'm not gonna go to Sephora and buy a $30, $40 foundation if I'm only gonna use it a couple times a year. And so the price of this makes it perfect. It has a beautiful finish, as you can see. It has an amazing price. It is definitely full coverage, but you can blend it down if you'd like to. I probably don't even need this much coverage, but you can always sheer it out. It's a really great buy. I just want to let you guys know that I will be reading from this book. My best friend Namia gave it to me, and it just has all the stuff that I'm going to be talking about in this video. She has a podcast. It's called the Small Talks Podcast. It's a critical thinking podcast where they talk about, or she talks about, different topics that are relevant to teens and even adults, and it's really great. She's the smartest person I know. Definitely check it out. So this is their hair density serum. So I was putting this on my eyebrows. They're growing in nice and thick. I also put it on my lashes. Please don't put this near your eyes. It burns. But when I was doing it, my lashes were growing in thick, so use at your discretion. But anywhere that you have hair that you want to grow nice and dense and thick, just lather this stuff on. It's amazing. I went through a phase when I was putting in puffs and ponytails and just getting it slick. And because of that, my edges were suffering, and this stuff brought it right back. Next is their 100% organic cold pressed rosehip seed oil, and it is also one of my favorite products. So rosehip seed oil is perfect for my kind of skin, and I have combination oily skin. So oily skin overproduces oleic acid and underproduces linoleic acid, which this happens to be rich in. Some people complained about the yellowish tinge rubbing off on their pillowcases. I haven't had that problem. I only use like 2 to 3 drops and I rub it all over my face, and because of all the products I've been layering, it just melts right into the skin. It doesn't really transfer. This is my second bottle and I'm just under halfway done. It's great stuff. Definitely check it out if you'd like an oil. Love it. You've probably seen this online. It's definitely one of their more popular products. This is the 7% glycolic acid toning solution. It's a toner. Just a heads up, I do dilute this stuff because the 7% is a little bit too strong for me. I pour out about this much and I fill it with water. I pour it into a separate container and I re-add it once I start to get low. But once diluted, this stuff is amazing. It has glycolic acid, which is an alpha hydroxy acid, or an AHA. What AHAs do is they're water soluble and they work to slow away dead skin cells and reveal the nice glowy skin underneath. This stuff is amazing. My skin always looks so glowy after I've been consistent with this stuff. It's definitely a great pickup. It has Tasmanian pepperberry, aloe vera, and glycerin. Glycerin is a humectant, so it attracts moisture. Aloe vera, naturally soothing anti-inflammatory ingredient. Tasmanian pepperberry, which The Ordinary loves to put in their products, is also great at soothing the skin. It does sting a little bit, but it's nothing you can't handle. It's not too bad, especially after you've been using it for a while. After you use it, your skin feels nice and supple and hydrated. It's a great buy. This is the 2% hyaluronic acid plus B5. And so hyaluronic acid has the ability to attract up to 1,000 times its weight in water. So it is a surface hydrator. It's really great. A lot of people with oily skin think that they need to mattify, but sometimes it's just because your skin is dehydrated and it's overcompensating with oil to make up for what it lacks in hydration. This is like my third bottle of this stuff, and ever since I've been using hyaluronic acid, my skin has been way more hydrated, my texture has been reduced, and I've noticed a huge decrease in the amount of oil my skin produces. This is definitely, like, if you have skin, I don't care if it's oily, if it's dry, get some hyaluronic acid. So the next product is something that I actually don't have on hand with me. I threw it away, so you can probably guess what I think of it. This is the salicylic acid 2% mask. It's basically salicylic acid, which I'll talk about a little bit later, mixed in with a couple clays and some other active ingredients to make a nice mask. It goes on black. I personally didn't like it too much. It's not that it affected my skin negatively. It actually didn't affect my skin at all, and that was the problem. I personally didn't really see a difference, and so I finished it before I threw it away, but ultimately it wasn't something that I opted to repurchase. Coincidentally, the next thing is their salicylic acid. So this is their salicylic acid 2%, and I personally use this as a spot treatment. I was about to go out and buy the Kate Somerville Eradicate or the Mario Badescu. Someone suggested that I try this out first, and I'm so glad I did. Every time I put this on an upcoming breakout, it's gone the next day, or if it's something that's already sprouted, over the course of a couple days, I'll keep applying this and it'll be gone, leaving no mark. Salicylic acid is a BHA, so they can go into the pore, they can exfoliate the inside, they break down all the sebaceous filaments, oil, dead skin, all that stuff that's in there, and they help with congestion. BHAs are personally my favorite because they target a lot of my skin concerns. I get a lot of whiteheads and sebaceous filaments, and this helps with that. It doesn't sting too much, just a tiny prick for a couple seconds, but I just don't put it all over my face, but you definitely could if you wanted to. Next is my absolute baby. This is alpha arbutin. And so alpha arbutin helps to lighten any hyperpigmentation, which is basically any scarring or dark marks left over from either, you know, scratching the surface of your skin or acne. This is my second bottle. And by the time I was either halfway or 3/4 done my first bottle, all of my hyperpigmentation was gone. This stuff is the bee's knees. If you are trying to get rid of hyperpigmentation, get you some of this. Alpha Arbutin is the bomb.com. So the next thing is also something I don't have because I threw it away because it hurt my soul. The Ordinary's Ascorbic Acid 8% and Alpha Arbutin 2%. So I thought ascorbic acid, which is also known as vitamin C, which is a powerful antioxidant that helps with hyperpigmentation, paired with my love and joy, alpha arbutin, would be an amazing pairing and help with my hyperpigmentation. Unfortunately, it had the ingredient dimethicone, which we know from my other video I'm allergic to. My skin broke out in hives, elevated chunks of skin, and it was just peeling like crazy for a good 2 weeks. So because of my allergy, that product just wasn't for me. So definitely check out some other reviews, but it's a no for me, dog. The niacinamide 10% and zinc 1%. So niacinamide, which is also known as vitamin B3, helps with congestion and clearing blemishes. It also has the ability to help brighten the skin over time. And then the zinc 1% helps with balancing sebum, which you know is one of my skin concerns. This is one of the first products from The Ordinary that I bought and tried, and it single-handedly helped clear my skin congestion in my nose and my forehead, which is where I break out the most. I'll just let the photos and videos speak for themselves, because if you pick up anything, pick up the niacinamide 10% and zinc 1%. It'll change your life. So next is the cult favorite, the TikTok famous. She doesn't need an introduction, or maybe she does. This is The Ordinary's 30% AHA, 2% BHA peeling solution. So this is an exfoliant. It's a mask, and you rub it all over your face and it's red. It's like the toner and all the other acids that I have talked about and will talk about. All in one, just a power punch of exfoliation and brightness and glowiness. After I use this mask about once every other week, I rotate it with my clay mask I talked about in my last video, so definitely go and check that out. One thing to mention though, if you're using this or any of the acids I mentioned, you might be being counterproductive if you are not wearing SPF. The thing about BHAs and AHAs especially is that they make your skin hypersensitive to UV rays. And so if you're not wearing an SPF and you go out into the sun, guess what? You're making your dark marks worse. Pinky promised me you're gonna wear SPF. You did it? Okay. I just wanted to let you know that pinky promises are actually law-binding contracts. And so if I catch you out here in these streets without SPF, you and I are gonna have a lawsuit. You and I both know that you just went out and spent all your money on the Ordinairy, so you can't afford this lawsuit. So, wear your SPF. Okay, and let me tell you how I get this stuff in Canada. Okay, so if you've seen this on TikTok or seen it anywhere, you've probably checked out the website only to find out to your dismay that the Ordinairy doesn't ship this to Canada. Why? Because in Canada, you have to get your dermatologist to recommend it to you. But Americans can just walk into the store, pick it off the shelf, and go and have amazing skin. It sucks, it sucks, it sucks, I know. I live in BC, which is just above the border into Washington State. I live about like a 30-minute drive away from the border, 20 minutes on a good day. And so my family has a mailbox over there. So I just order it online to my mailbox and I drive and I pick it up when we're shopping across the border. I'm sorry, I personally don't have a magic hack. So the next product, which I don't have with me, unfortunately, is their Natural Moisturizing Factors Moisturizer. And this has hyaluronic acid in it. I prefer more jelly consistencies, and it was a bit too rich for my kind of skin. So it increased the amount of milia and stuff under my eye. But if you have dry skin, definitely check it out. Next is this baby over here, and this is the Ordinary's L-Ascorbic Acid Powder. As we know already, L-Ascorbic Acid, or ascorbic acid, is AKA for vitamin C. If on the off chance you randomly get some hyperpigmentation and you want to solve it, but you absolutely love your skincare and you have a serum that's amazing, but it doesn't target hyperpigmentation, this baby comes in clutch because it's a nice, finely milled powder. And they include this adorable, look at how cute this is. They include this adorable little scoopula, and you can literally just scoop some powder, put it in your amazing serum, and bam, your serum now has vitamin C in it. It's great. I will mention though, it is a little bit grainy, so you do end up having to use a little bit more of your serum than you normally would to make it a nice spreadable consistency. But other than that, it's pretty great. I've been loving it. And loving having vitamin C in my hyaluronic acid serum. Do not use it in conjunction with niacinamide. They just make each other ineffective, so don't do that, but not a bad pickup, especially for $5.20. Next is their Mandelic Acid. This stuff was actually pretty good. Mandelic Acid is, again, an AHA, so it's an exfoliant, and it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't strong enough for me because I've been using all these other stronger, especially that peel. I've been using these stronger AHAs. This wasn't pulling the heavy-duty job that I was used to, but for those of you with sensitive skin, this stuff is amazing. If all those other acids and peels that I mentioned earlier are a bit too strong for your skin, definitely give this a try. It's one of the more gentler AHAs, so there's something out there for everyone. Give it a go. There's only two products from the Ordinary that I absolutely despise. One of which is their lactic acid 10% plus hyaluronic acid. Does it have hyaluronic acid? Yeah, they put hyaluronic acid in everything, which is amazing. But this stuff broke me up so bad. My skin was... We don't talk about what happened. Personally, I think I grabbed too strong of a concentration. It also comes in a 5% concentration, which probably would have been better for me. I would start with the 5%, and if that's not doing it for you, go up to the 10%, but don't start high and go low like I did. This is the 0.2% retinol in squalane, or squalene, whichever one it is. But point is, this stuff messed up my skin. And I just want to say that I probably shouldn't have even been using this, because what retinol does is it targets signs of fine lines, aging, and things like that. So from the description of what it does, it's probably for more mature skin. I don't have mature skin, so this wasn't targeting what I needed to target. But just like the lactic acid, this stuff broke me out a lot. So that is all for today. Thank you for watching. Wear your SPF. And I'll catch you in the next one.